Hello everyone, this is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self. Welcome to the Satsang with the Self. In these Satsang videos, I channel the Higher Self for you. The Higher Self is a greater state of intelligence, awareness, and energy that we are all one with. Essentially, we are all part of a universal intelligence, all of creation. Everything we are and everything that we experience, it's all the same eternal state. It's one consciousness appearing as all of these forms. The more we go into ourselves and transcend the physical forms of reality, the greater we experience our own state of oneness. In meditation or in states of non-physical reality, we're able to more directly experience ourselves as this original state of universal consciousness. In these videos, I enter this state for you, and I bring through information and energy to support you on your own journey of awakening. The awakening process is ourselves remembering that we are eternal souls, and then expanding even beyond the experience of an individual soul to realize ourselves as the universal consciousness. These teachings help you at every step of this process by giving you greater mastery over your human mind and your human emotions, as well as your human body. These teachings also help you to understand the greater parts of your non-physical self and ultimately help you to experience the fullest states of your God consciousness. For many years, I've created these video teachings to help you. If you have interest in any specific topics, please visit my website. And chances are I'll have already channeled upon it and you can find something interesting and supportive. For these videos, sometimes I bring through information based upon the suggestion of audience members. For this video, I will channel upon the topic of the pineal gland and provide a meditation for you. I hope that you enjoy this channeling. I hope that it helps you on your soul's path of awakening. Okay, I'll now begin. Dear One, close your eyes. Feel the center of your chest. Be at peace. Relax into yourself. Relax into the feeling of your heart. Notice this soft feeling of peace and love. Relax into your body and its natural movement of breathing. In every moment you exist, you appear as an open state of perception. You have no form as the state of perception, and you hold within yourself all the forms of creation. Notice yourself as this open emptiness. Feel the space of your mind, the space of your perception. Feel yourself as this open emptiness. Allow your heart to shine its quality of energy. Allow your body to move with its breathing. And experience yourself as the empty container, having this present moment. While you do this, you are increasing the qualities of the emptiness. That which you focus on, your invisible hand of God consciousness, your invisible creative energy, increases. So you focus on being the emptiness, and the qualities of emptiness increase. You are the creator that cannot be seen, but you witness the changes that you create. So notice the emptiness of your own awareness and watch how those qualities expand. Allow the stillness and silence to grow. Notice these qualities expanding. Be here as the awareness, always at peace, always empty, always holding the forms of life. Part of the challenge of meditation is learning how to remain focused on this empty, open quality while allowing the forms to be as they are. Feel the emptiness. Feel the space of your own mind's awareness. Feel the space of this world, and whatever forms appear, whether in the world or as your body, even as the emotions or the mind, whatever forms appear, allow them to be as they are. Forms will arise, and forms will change, and forms will vanish. Allow the forms to be themselves. You are here focused on the feeling of emptiness, focused on being this all-embracing emptiness. Continue focusing in the empty space of your mind. Continue feeling yourself as the empty space of this world. While you perform it in this way, your pineal gland is already awakening. Your pineal gland is related to the qualities of sleep and non-physical perception. So while you focus on non-physical perception, feeling the space, being the emptiness, automatically the pineal gland is awakening. Continue feeling the empty quality, allowing it to grow. Continue being this open, empty awareness. You are moving from physical perception into non-physical perception. And this process begins by feeling yourself becoming empty. Feel the space. Feel yourself being this emptiness. While you're here feeling the space, also look into the darkness of your closed eyes. With relaxation, simply look into the darkness of this space. Continue feeling yourself as the open space. And look into this darkness. Our focus is relaxed. We do not want to strain the muscles of the eyes. We simply look in the most relaxed way. While you're doing this, bring the tip of your tongue and touch the roof of your mouth. Simply rest your tongue in the location that feels comfortable, placing the tip of your tongue into the roof of your mouth. Very gentle pressure, no straining of the muscles. This will help to build an energetic bridge. Continue feeling yourself as the open space. Continue looking into the darkness. And feel very gently the tongue touching the roof of the mouth. continue performing this simple practice, being in the state of awareness, being present, completely allowing the forms to be as they are. You are here simply observing, focused on feeling the emptiness, focused on perceiving the darkness. Look into the darkness. You exist as a multidimensional consciousness. What you focus on expands. Focus into the darkness and feel yourself as the space of your mind. Your mind is its own environment, and as you focus here, the dark space will create an appearance of size and shape. You will feel like the darkness is becoming an open container, and you are perceiving into it. Continue focusing. You are creating this expansion. As you look here, understand that you are allowing yourself to move into a non-physical space of perception. You are the space of consciousness, and you are looking into the space of your mind. Continue feeling the space. Continue looking into your mind's eye. That which arises is perfect right now. Allow it to be. Allow it to appear. You are the open emptiness. You are focused on the empty space of your mind. And now, dear ones, we have opened this container and we are going to raise its vibration of life energy. Continue feeling yourself as the open state. Continue looking into your mind's eye. With the tongue pressed gently into the roof of your mouth, take your mind's awareness and draw an imaginary line from the bottom of your spine, from your root chakra, up the spine into the center of the brain. When you reach the center of the brain, stop there, be relaxed. Wait a few moments, and then draw the line again. Start at the bottom of your spine, the area between your legs. Draw a line with your mind's focus up into the center of your brain. Relax there. Notice the change it creates. After a few moments, perform it again. Draw the line with your mind up your chakra system into the pineal gland area at the center of your brain. So do this now at your own natural rhythm. You are being the awareness, feeling yourself as this open, silent space, and you are drawing this line of energy up the body into the brain. Continue doing this. After your next movement up, stay focused. Look into the dark space of your mind. You may stop the movement now. Continue feeling yourself as the emptiness while looking into the space of your mind. Once more, draw the line from the bottom of your spine up the central channel into the center of your brain, into that place where it feels like you are looking out into the mind's space. Relax when you have arrived. Be present there, and a few moments later, draw the line again, and continue this process, drawing the line up, relaxing in your brain area. Drawing the line again when you feel intuitively guided. Allow it to be natural. You're very relaxed. You're open and aware. And you're moving this current of energy while you draw this line. You are channeling more energy into the pineal gland, and this will increase your perception in your mind's eye. You will feel the space of your mind's awareness opening. You will feel yourself more present as this inner observer. and the forms of your mind, they will awaken. Continue drawing this line. A few more movements drawing the line. You are the awareness perceiving into this container, and you are channeling energy to awaken it. After you draw the next line up, stay focused in that space behind your closed eyes and feel yourself as this container of perception. Stop the line drawing and stay focused here. And now, be relaxed, stay focused here, while we instruct you. We want you now to look into your mind's eye, and notice what you see when you take yourself to the surface of the sun. What do you see in your mind's eye while you project your consciousness to look around the surface of the sun? And just observe what you see in your mind's eye. And look around this location in the same way you would look around the world. Do you see any forms on the surface of the sun? Do you see other forms of life on the surface of the sun? And if you see any forms, you may approach them in a very natural way. Watch the form coming closer to you as you desire to approach it. You are a mind. You can simply go towards the form. How does the form appear now? Is the form showing you something? Allow yourself now to explore the surface of the sun and any forms of life you perceive. Just observe. Just watch. And take your awareness around this non-physical location. We will give you a few moments until we speak with you again. Continue looking. The space of your mind may grow larger in size. You may feel yourself becoming more non-physical as you allow yourself to perceive into this reality. Simply observe. What is in the environment? Look around. Go to forms. Interact with the forms you perceive. We will be silent while you do this. Now, allow yourself to express your love and gratitude to any forms you are perceiving and interacting with. Feel your heart, the non-physical energetic feeling of light. And feel yourself shining your gratitude into this location and into the forms of life. And now we are going to direct your awareness to a second location. Before we take you there, relax again into the emptiness of your perception. Feel yourself as the empty space looking into this darkness. Feel yourself as a non-physical, open field of awareness. And you are looking into life. And now, while being this open space, allow a journey to continue. Allow yourself to now go towards a place that you consider your home. Allow this to form within your awareness. Allow your mind to show you a place you consider your home. Whatever appears, allow it to be, and like before, look around this environment and notice what you are perceiving. It's all in your mind's eye, and your mind is a non-physical body of light that exists beyond the limits of time and space. Allow your mind to perceive an important place you consider your home, and look around and explore it. Interact with the forms you perceive. continue looking into the space of your mind. Share gratitude now with what you are perceiving. Feel your heart's love and shine it into the mind and onto the forms you are perceiving. You may now focus on the darkness of your mind's awareness. This will effectively empty the vision, returning back to a void state of perception. Relax into the state of being an empty awareness. Look into the dark space, being it, feeling yourself as this mind of awareness. We will take you on one more journey now. While looking into this dark open space, ask your higher self to bring to you a vision of a future experience that benefits how you live your life. Allow the universe to show you in your mind's eye a future experience that will benefit you right now. And let the vision take shape. Your higher self will guide it. Just observe and allow the vision to be revealed to you. Continue noticing what is being given to you. We'll stay a few moments longer with this vision. Allow your higher mind to show you that which benefits you right now. And now, allow yourself to be this open space and feel your gratitude for that which is being shown to you, and feel your gratitude for your higher self intelligence that is supporting your soul's awakening. So feel your spiritual heart and feel your love shining into this vision. Feel your love, your heart's radiance, shining light into this vision of your mind. You may now relax. Relax into the dark, open space of your mind's eye. And feel your heart. Feel your chest of your physical body now. And notice your physical breathing. And gently guide your breathing. We're coming back into the physical reality. And notice how you change, how you start feeling different as you come back into your body awareness. Feel yourself as the awareness with your body expanding in your perception. You're noticing that the shape of the body is becoming more known. The vibration of the body is becoming more known. You're feeling yourself returning to this physical dimension. Gently guide your breathing. Feel your body's movement. We want you to listen to us while you're staying aware of your physical body. We don't want you to drift back out into a state of meditation. We want you to integrate the experiences you've just had. The pineal gland one is a physical organ, therefore it is a physical representation of a non-physical experience. All physical forms are representations of non-physical creations. Everything you perceive physically first began as a non-physical creation. The pineal gland represents perception of non-physical reality. So when we have experiences, genuine experiences of non-physical reality, the pineal gland becomes more active. When you fall asleep at night, the pineal gland produces its chemicals. There are many meditations that have you put things into this physical organ. Imagine colors and lights and try to channel things there, but most of them do not even stimulate the pineal gland. Many of them just stimulate the pituitary gland or other parts of the human body. If you are doing a meditation that wakes you up and changes more physical things, it's most likely stimulating the pituitary gland. The pituitary gland is a gland that represents the perception of and the expression into the physical reality. So a lot of times people believe they're actually working with their pineal gland when what they're actually doing is stimulating physical creation. And that's gonna skip touching the pineal, and it's going to go right to the pituitary gland. The pineal gland is activated when we experience non-physical reality. And so we see this when we sleep at night. We see this when we take hallucinogenic plants that give us a greater perception of non-physical reality. And we also see this at the time of passing on to death, onto the next dimension. So the pineal gland is a representation of an experience, just like all physical forms represent non-physical things. So in this meditation, we guided you into an experience that is directly related to this organ. We didn't imagine the organ. We didn't channel anything into the organ. Instead, we create it in a way that is genuinely connected to this organ. The more that you see the non-physical, the more that the pineal gland gets stimulated. It's not necessary to try to stimulate the pineal gland or to try to awaken its function. What's better is try to perceive non-physically. Develop the skill of focusing into that empty space of your mind. That's where you go when you fall asleep and dream at night. Now, like the dreaming state, the lens of non-physical awareness awakens and you perceive into the space of your mind. But when you are not guiding the experience, when your conscious presence isn't strong enough, then the memory-based conditioning begins to project the content into the space of your mind. So you dream. When you fall asleep, you awaken that container of perception. And if you're awake enough when you fall asleep, or when you're awake enough in this type of meditation that we guided you on today, you will not have automatic dreams appearing. When your presence is strong enough as a consciousness, the space will just stay empty and expanded, and it'll feel like you're looking into another reality. In the beginning, it might feel vague, not very clear, not very specific, not very well defined. But the more you practice, the more definition it'll have. The more it'll feel like you're actually going somewhere, that you're actually looking into a field of empty, open darkness. And again, when you're just being the awareness, looking into the void space, nothing will be there. But as soon as you create a desire, an intention, then your mind will go to that experience. When we did this with you, we wanted you to just form the intention and then let anything happen. While you stay connected into that open container of perception, you're just allowing whatever's going to happen to arise. No judgment, no control. Our focus and effort is on maintaining this field of non-physical perception. And we allow ourselves to have the experience that's presented to us. We just create the intention, and everything else happens. You don't need to imagine anything. In fact, if you start imagining things, then it's like you're dreaming. You're lucid dreaming, and that's different than seeing non-physical reality. When you start imagining things, you are having a lucid dream. You are projecting the content into your vision. When you're not awake enough, the subconscious mind, your memory, projects the content into your vision. So there is dreaming, where your subconscious memory-based understanding is presented to you. It projects the content into that open void state. There is lucid dreaming, where you consciously imagine something and you put it there. And there is the focused intention to be shown something. And you set the intention, you direct what the universe will show to you. That third part is what we were doing with you. And that's how you learn to see with your third eye. That's how you learn to go to places, to travel into experiences, and to receive information. So oftentimes people are doing these meditations and they're not really effective for the act of seeing. Many psychics cannot see because they're lucid dreaming. They don't understand the difference. Some of them are just dreaming and they're telling you what their memory creates, and they told you about something they read the other day. They told you about something that they really, really want to be true, and they start telling you that that's your future. Perhaps they just listen to you talk and you tell them all about your life and they just start repeating back to you what you said from their memory. They're not seeing anything that's out there. Maybe their third eye is open, but they're filling it with their own memory-based content. And there are many times we do spiritual practices, trying to see things in the pineal gland, which essentially is just an organ that represents a deeper non-physical process. But we're trying to see things in our pineal gland, in our mind's eye state. And we just create the imagination. If you are instructed, visualize this, then you are lucid dreaming into the mind's eye, and you're seeing whatever you create. Maybe the instructor tells you what to envision. Maybe your memory influences what you're imagining. You are putting into this open container your own creation, and you'll witness it, and it'll be very real, because you're putting it into your mind. And the third way, as we have said already, the third way is to not put anything accept an intention, an invitation to the universe. Show me this. Take me here. Help me to see. Give me a vision. Let me understand. You are essentially opening up your consciousness, your mind's eye, and inviting the universe to fill it. Not your memory, not your subconscious memory like a dream, and not your conscious imagination from your personal will. You're inviting the universe to fill your mind's eye. So we wanted to guide you on something effective because the great majority of pineal gland meditations, they are doing one of the first two things. You are imagining something, or the instructor is telling you what to see, or just the memory is putting something in your mind. You're not really connecting to the universe of non-physical reality outside of your brain. You're still in your brain. You think it's the pineal gland that you're stimulating. Really, it's the pituitary gland. That's why you're feeling so awake and energized, so happy and charged up. You're putting energy into your physical body. And as a result, you're perceiving your physical body get all excited. There are meditations that get you excited. Right? They use music to stimulate your ears, to have you feeling emotion. You think, oh, that's my pineal gland awakening. No, it's not. That's you becoming more perceptive of what's happening in the physical reality. So in a way, yes, your mind is expanding, but what's being put into your mind's consciousness are physical things. The music, the feeling of every sound, and how that's stimulating your chakras in your body with your emotions. Your mind is always active in every experience you're having, but the act of going somewhere, of journeying, or of seeing non-physically requires you to leave the body behind. So your physical environment has to be very relaxed. You cannot have loud sounds. You cannot have bright flashing lights. You cannot have strong stimulation on your physical body. If you're stimulating your physical body, the content of your body will fill your mind's eye. Your third eye is always happening, but are you focusing it on your own thoughts, like seeing your memories in your mind? Are you focusing on your own emotions, seeing the story of your past expressed through your chakras? Or are you taking your consciousness beyond your physical body's communication structure? Are you projecting your consciousness into the field of the universe outside of your own personal creative form? Are you transcending your human state? So there are many teachers, they don't understand it in the way that we do. We try to explain it to you so you gain valuable wisdom, so you can place exactly what is happening. Far too often in spirituality, we just assume things. We do it in the human world as well. We don't really understand what's happening, how does it happen, and how can we differentiate this form from that form. You see, for some of you, dear one, an apple is an apple. Now, as you know, we love to talk about apples. Beautiful, beautiful things. For some of you, an apple is an apple. But for others, an apple is a pink lady apple. Or an apple is a red delicious. Or perhaps it is a honey crisp. Perhaps it is a Fuji apple. You see, an apple might have a similar shape, similar colors even, but they're different in subtle ways. And you can say, ah, yes, this is this type of apple, and that is that type of apple, and here is a third type of apple. For those of you who have taken the time to observe apples, you will notice all the different variety of apples. Some say hundreds of years ago there were over 200 different types of apples, 200 flavors. You're lucky if your food store has but 5 different flavors of apple. 200 different flavors. Remarkable. And someone, in fact, many people, they all came together and they learned the fine qualities of this and how it makes it different than that. And we're trying to teach you in the same way. How can we feel the difference between my memory dreaming something into my mind's eye and a lucid dream in which I'm willfully imagining it and a vision that is being given to me from a consciousness outside of my personal mind's creation? How can I notice that each one feels different? Each one happens in a different feeling of my brain. Because remember, the different areas of your body, the organs or locations, they represent different physical processes. And so if it's a memory-based imagination, a different part of your physical brain will be at work. It'll fire with more electricity. And you will sense it differently in your state of perception. Memories perceived by you are different than imaginations that appear in your awareness. And they're different than receiving visions. They're all different, just like the flavors of apple. But oftentimes people think, oh, just grab me an apple. And they pick whatever one has a price or whatever one is most convenient. They just pick something, not realizing there are all these different variety of apples. And they all appear differently. And they all give us a different experience. They all have unique significance. So we don't want you to assume that everything you see in your mind is a vision. For most people, they haven't even freed themselves from the shell of their own personal mind. Your mind is a container of energy. Just like a chicken is inside an egg before it grows up and becomes a greater expression of itself in the world, so too are you inside of the shell of your personal mind. So when you hear a lot of thoughts and you have a lot of emotions, and you feel like you're stuck in this human body and stuck in this reality, you might feel a boundary of yourself. And it feels very dense, like there's a wall in your perception, an energetic wall, and you can't get out of it. You cannot expand beyond it. And when you look in your pineal gland, all you see are your own mind's creations. You can do the visualization practices, and they work quite well, perhaps. You can see them, you can feel them. You're stimulating your personal mind very, very well with these visualizations. And they're effective for their purpose. You generate feelings, you change your understanding. You're working inside your mind. But that's different than expanding beyond your human container. So at a certain stage of the awakening process, we expand beyond the shell of our ego, beyond the boundary of our personal mind. We start to expand into the space that fills the present moment, just like we instruct you in every one of our teachings. In the beginning of every channeling, we instruct you, expand your consciousness and feel yourself filling the present moment. We're guiding you to transcend the structure. It's an actual container, and it feels like it has a shell around it. We're guiding you to transcend your human physical self and become a greater experience of your non-physical expanded self, the one that can travel through time, the one that can perceive in multiple locations at once, the one that's not limited by the physical laws. Because your mind is not a physical form. Your mental body, we should say, is not a physical form. Your human understanding, that's held within this energy field that is just a short distance away from your physical body. But your mind, your mental body, it's a ball of radiant light, and that light can just grow and grow and grow. You can use the practice we gave you on your own. If you don't need the instruction that follows, simply stop it at the end of the channeling. But we do want you to come back into your body when you're done. Don't just leave yourself floating out there and then quickly get up. Come back into your body. Reconnect. Otherwise, you'll be forgetful. You'll have difficulty controlling your physical limbs. You'll drop objects. It'll be difficult to function if you leave yourself too non-physically based. It's beautiful. You go non-physical every night. You go non-physical in meditation sometimes. Even randomly throughout your day, you may find yourself losing awareness, like, where did I go? Well, you went non-physical. Now, were you in your mind or were you out there in the universe? You have to notice what's happening. This steel one is a wonderful practice to do late at night and then to fall asleep afterwards. If you're falling asleep afterwards, you don't really have to come back into your body at the end. You can stop the recording and then just stay in that expanded state. And every time you fall asleep, this is where you go. But for many of you, you stay focused inside the shell of your human mind. You don't really expand outside of it. Our guidance is helping you to expand outside of it so you can perceive more of reality. Now, in this meditation, we've chose three different places for you to go, but you can set your own intentions. You can allow yourself to perceive whatever is there, whatever you wish. It's really your mind to use, so take it where you want. When we asked you to go to your home, perhaps today it goes somewhere, tomorrow it goes somewhere else. These experiences are just opening you up because you've had many lifetimes. You identify from coming from many different realms, many different planets, people often call them, many different locations. For some, it might go into this lifetime and you realize the significance of my home is really certain aspects of this lifetime. Home, dear one, is some place we identify with, a place with strong emotional connection. It doesn't mean I was born there as a soul. You're born in the heart of God. You exist for eternity. Right? But you may have spent a lot of time and created an emotional connection to this planet or this lifetime or these people or this physical structure. Home has a feeling of connection. So when you say, go to a place that is home for me, that's significant, someplace I consider my home, I call my home, I feel like is home. And you're going to a place that has a meaningful connection. So enjoy this meditation. Give yourself time. Remember, you must relax and go non-physical to make this genuine. So we gave you more space. We created a calm energy for you. Using this recording will help you because you're connecting into our energy and the energy of everyone who's using it. And so this will help you in your own journey of awakening. So that's it, everyone. That's the teaching for today. That's the guided meditation. We hope that you enjoyed it. We want you to continue to enjoy it. It can be powerful as it helps you awaken in your life. With that, dear one, we will end today's communication. Many blessings, much love, namaste. Thank you.